back for the final taping of the day. This one is tremendous, recommended by Appeals to Manjushri, Longchenpa, the already there, the great practices. Here is a great, great practice. It's kind of like a skateboard trick, so, you know, I'm introducing these practices like, try this, try this. Well, this one is just great. So, we're going to get right to it. The gist of this is that you are observing. You're an observer. You're just the observer. And there's this self, what you call yourself. And yourself rises up like from the depths of an ocean, and it surfaces and it's enlightened. So that an enlightened self arises in your in your awareness, and there it is, it's an enlightened self. Okay, don't react. Now the enlightened self then begins to sink, and it sinks back beneath the waves, the ocean, into the inky darkness, and it's now become a deluded self. Don't react. Enlightened self comes, enlightened self goes. Okay, enlightened self comes, enlightened self goes. Don't react to either one. So imagine that you're enlightened. There's an enlightened self right there. Don't react. Don't grasp. Don't grasp. Don't ask questions of it. Don't react. Be indifferent to it. Be indifferent. Be indifferent. What we're practicing here is called high indifference. Franklin Merrill Wolfe used that term here in California. High indifference. So we're practicing high indifference with a shout out to Franklin Merrill Wolfe, someone that was enlightened here in California. Well, we won't say enlightened, he had high indifference. So, high indifference. Practicing this high indifference. We're indifferent to enlightenment, and we're indifferent to non-enlightenment. Equally indifferent to both. So get yourself settled in. And just get your feet wet with this. That's what we're doing. We're just getting our feet wet with this. This is quite an extraordinary step to take. So yourself is an abidance now. It's abiding. It's an enlightenment. Okay? Don't react. Be indifferent to this. Now yourself has identified with duality and modification. Okay? Don't react to that. Be indifferent to that. What is enlightened can also be unenlightened. Keep this, all right? Keep this in mind. What is enlightened can also be unenlightened. We are neither the unenlightened self, nor are we the enlightened self. We are neither one. So this is sending shockwaves through me. Just the audacity to even sit here and consider this. I am neither the enlightened self, nor am I the unenlightened self. We are taught that we have to search for the enlightened self, find it, but I am neither one. I'm indifferent to both of them. I am indifferent to both of them. So, just dipping our toes in the pool here. That's the first step. Let enlightenment come and let enlightenment go. You're not attached to enlightenment. This is causing a revolution within my mind. All sorts of reactions are ping-ponging around, just wow. Complete landscape shift. Now this practice came up in a video I made called Kali Ross, 360 degree pranam, which was just a spontaneous taping. At least it started out to be. I did this great taping, and then I went to look at it to see how to do it, and it turns out I didn't turn the camera on. So I had to do it a second time. So it was different. The second time was different. It was, both of them were good. And the second time I came up with it, came up with this just, hey, let enlightenment come, let enlightenment go. The enlightened self is walking past you, let it walk past you. The unenlightened self is walking past you, let it walk past you. Don't make any move toward either one. Don't do anything with either one. So I did a flipping the script video, 2.5 hours of very intense explanation and flipping the script, clarifications. Then I did 3 short videos today, humorous, introducing some characters that may help us out. Characterizations, Uncle Ross, Kali Ross, and Juan Carlos, the most disinterested man in the world. Yeah. And these things help balance out our path. Now, this one is a practice video. Very audacious, what we're saying here. I'm equally indifferent to enlightened self and unenlightened self. Now, we're just saying this, committed to it, agreeing and accepting it. This is the shock. You know, in a particular bliss or anything. I'm not aiming for anything except just to practice. Get familiar with actually doing it. Just do it. Don't aim for anything other than actually just doing it. As soon as you're aiming for a result, you're getting in your own way. Don't aim for any result. Just trust it. Whatever is enlightened can also be unenlightened. Keep this in mind. So we are practicing being equally indifferent to both enlightened and unenlightened self. Wow. super intense practice. I'm feeling all sorts of reactions. But we just full stop in the wow. So we relax. So this is extremely surprising to my psyche to practice this. But it's the first step to getting used to it. Enlightened self, I'm not interested. Unenlightened self, I'm not interested. The most disinterested man in the world. So I've just sort of entered this state that I don't really know what kind of state it is, so it doesn't matter. Okay, so the shock was worn off a little bit. You can feel it, and suddenly it suddenly you seem to have come back to a more, more familiar state. Just it just sort of drops away, and then suddenly you feel that you feel normal again. So that was a perfect example of full shot, full stop in the wow from extraordinary practice. Disc-free space. I have a lot of disc-free space. Great. Yeah. We can tape all night. Don't tempt me. I might do that. Interesting. When you give up grasping at enlightened self, you know what? Unenlightened self then isn't interesting at all. What's the point? You just pay no attention to it anymore, anymore, because you're not trying to enlighten it at all, because you're not grasping an enlightened self either. Amazing. The two disappear together, they go together. That's what I'm experiencing. You want to drop the world, then drop enlightened self, and everything else will go with it. Had this practice this morning. I asked for a practice this morning. Petition, receive, practice, right? But mind your PRPs. Every day, mind your PRPs. So I asked for a practice this morning. And what I did was, I saw the entire world as this pale ashen color. Everything was exactly the same mottled, pale, mottled, ashen color, like ash, everything. There was no color in the world at all. In fact, that was yesterday that I had that practice, I think. Yeah, it was yesterday. No color anywhere. Everything was exactly the same hue of this gray, pale gray color, like volcanic ash or something. Everything. The entire world, there was not even a speck of color except for this gray, ashen gray. And everything was just total monocolor. That's it. And I just practiced that, seeing that. I just practice viewing the world that way. All bodies, all animals, it's everything the same color. Just this nondescript, bland, ashen gray. And after a while, I just felt this, the interest in the world just dropping away. So when Buddha mind arises, take no mind of it. When the samsaric mind arises, take no mind of it. So we're just practicing. We're not trying to establish anything. We're just practicing getting used to doing this. So it means absolutely nothing to me. Enlightened self or unenlightened self means absolutely nothing to me. Now, very interesting. This is the primal, true awareness of intrinsic spaciousness speaking in this way. And I can see that our trouble has been that the so-called enlightened self has been trying to impress this awareness that, hey, I'm enlightened. You know, you need to accept that this is important. So we've been trying to modify our reactions of our true self by claiming there's this enlightened self. So really, our reactions are already right. No reaction. So we already have what we're seeking for, which is no reaction. Amazing. See, we think enlightenment is to get this the awareness to react to our enlightenment. We're trying to get it to react. It doesn't react. It's indifferent, completely indifferent. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to change that high indifference. And this is the completely false approach. Don't try to change the high indifference. It's already highly indifferent. This is what we need. I am the high indifference. Skate the board of high indifference. So we're just getting used to this. That's it. We're not going to, try to force some result. Don't force results. They will arise on their own when you don't force them. So see, high enlightenment, high indifference, that's really enlightenment, true, our true self. And it's our attempt to modify high indifference and get a reaction to so-called enlightened self. This is the fake self, the false duality. And we keep thinking something's wrong with ourselves. Isn't that amazing? There's something wrong with myself. Myself's not interested in enlightenment. No, that is the self. That is the true self, not interested in enlightenment. Total high indifference to it. So we think our job is to get it, caring about it, enlightenment, but it never does. And we think, oh, there's something wrong with us. No, there's nothing wrong with us. That's the right indifference to have. We should be indifferent to it entirely. So the practice is to dare to go into this and see what happens. Just be real quiet because you don't know what. Just be real still and quiet and so many pieces are moving on the chessboard right now. Don't make an assessment of what the landscape will look like. Just be patient. Everything's on the move now. In my mind, everything's on the move. Seems like I don't know what the landscape will be. So this is a great practice, just indifferent to it. So this has been a very amazing practice just to dare to do it. You have to have really great spiritual fitness to do this. Completely flips the script on everything, doesn't it? All our interpretations have turned out to be have been backwards. We think there's something wrong with the true self because it's indifferent to our quest for enlightenment. It seems indifferent. It's indifferent to it. I think, wow, there's something wrong. I got to impress it more. You know, it's I don't know how to impress the true self here with my enlightenment. What kind of enlightenment, you know, do I need to impress it? Nothing impresses it. Nothing makes an impression upon it. I am that. So, this is an example of sitting quietly. Don't move. Don't move your mind. There's a lot going on now. In my mind, there's a lot going on. Just don't identify with it. Don't follow. Don't do anything about it. Just wow it. So now I have to consciously use the wow, because my mind is trying to orient itself somehow, trying to get my orientation back, but this is no good. You have to just say, wow, I'm not going to do anything. I'm not going to think about positive or negative or any sort of clarity one way or another, muddiness. I'm not going to struggle for anything. Full stop in the wow. Don't try to visualize anything. It's like the city's on fire. Just let it burn. What can you do? Just let it burn. And you'll find out later on what's burned and what hasn't. Just don't react to anything. So, this is a tough one. I'm struggling with it. So just wow the struggle. That's part of the whole situation. Just wow that. What? Okay. Sorry. Okay. Maybe that's a sign. So I can see why this practice has been held off. You have to be confident enough that where you feel some struggle and some failure and some don't know what to make of it all, just wow that. This is like throwing a catalyst into your mind and seeing what happens. Really. So don't follow what happens in your mind. Just stick with a wow. Just wow. Lots going on. Don't try to determine what's going on. Okay, what's going on? I'm interested in my mind. Don't be interested in your mind. It's what's going on is settling down, generalizing. It'll happen on its own. Don't engage with it. Don't think you have to follow it at all. Yeah. Just trust it. There's a lot going on, for sure. Okay? That's all you need to know. A lot going on. I don't need to know specifically what's going on. It's not important. I've done my work. Now let the gravity of it, you know, do its work. Like that. Okay. So, how do we do? 40 minutes? Yeah. It's, that's just, there's just reverberations going on everywhere. And so don't measure them. Don't try to account for them. Just don't be interested in them. We know they're going on, but we don't need to identify, catalog, detail, describe. Don't try to describe. This is why the habit of describing and explaining gets in the way and prevents this higher type of practicing, gets in the way. Because if you have that habit, you will be overwhelmed by this. So we have to practice the habit of not describing, not detailing, not representing, not expressing, just being disinterested in the mental activity, whatever's going on. It's not important. We're just wow, the whole thing. Wow, that's all. That's our description. Wow. What's going on in your mind? Wow. So practice the wow. It's all that we have to say. Just wow, 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 wow. And we avoid then getting pulled into all this vast whatever's going on. I'm not going to describe it. It just feels like a title shift, a complete title shift, or, you know, it's just, but I don't even pay attention to that, just wow. But obviously, I can feel that this just fundamentally altered everything. So just let it, don't try to take pictures of it, represent it, describe, explain, catalog, find parts of it, pieces of it. Try to structure it. Try to make sense of it. Try to understand it. Don't do anything except just wow. Full stop in the wow. Don't even post on Facebook about it. Of course, we have this video, but we're doing in the wow at this point. So you just wow, 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 wow. Nothing in specific is wowish, just the whole thing is wowish. Just the entire situation is very wowish. That's all we focus on. That's it. Now, if you're practicing this wow, you may completely forget what it was that brought up the wow. Just You have no idea what you just went through. You've lost interest in it. It's just that this is it. You're just practicing the wow, and you forget about what have I been doing the last 45 minutes? I don't know. It's not important. A wow has arisen, so I must have done something. I don't remember what it was. Doesn't matter. Whatever it was, it's having a catalytic effect. So just trust it, but I don't remember even what it was that I brought up. Don't try to remember. Don't try to remember at this point. Don't struggle to remember. No, it doesn't matter. What matters is that we just ride this out. So extreme, obviously extreme upheaval. But in the wow, we don't even know what happened. We're just wow. It's very, very wowish, that's all. Don't know what happened exactly. Doesn't matter. So, wow. Okay, that's about it for the day, right? Big day. So now I become aware of why it's so important to practice full stop in the wow. Otherwise, you will simply be totally overwhelmed by mental processes, mental shifts, mental changes, as if something's important is taking place. Nothing's important. Nothing important is taking place at all. Nothing whatsoever. Disinterested in all of it anyway, so it doesn't matter. Disinterested in enlightenment, disinterested in unenlightenment, and everything in between. So in the wow, you're not interested in any specifics or what did I do, retrospect or anything. No retrospect. You're right here, right now, feeling what you're feeling and not giving any cause for it, not worrying about the cause. The feeling is here. It's caused. Okay, so you just stay with it. I can see why I was leery of doing this. I keep saying to everyone, practice, practice. Well, I practiced what I preached and jumped into this. Don't peek for any results. Don't peek. Don't peek for any results. Don't peek. Now, I'm not going to go on Facebook. I'm just going to take it easy and then go to bed. Don't peek at anything. Don't be interested. Okay, what happened? Now, I'm not interested in what happened. I'm just interested in staying in the wow. What a day. I think it's time to call it a day. The wow is still there. This is a very, very, very challenging one, but we're doing fine. And I'll just stay in it as I turn in for the night. Okay, very great. That's it for this one.